Park is replaced by Go Media Mount Smart Stadium, where the All Blacks have played just once prior. Tēnā koutou katoa, nō mai haere mai, kleno, and welcome to the greatest rivalry in world rugby, the All Blacks against the Springboks, the first of two clashes between these two heavyweights before the Rugby World Cup. Tonight I'm joined in commentary by two former All Black greats, Jeff Wilson and firstly, Mills Moliaina.
Kia ora tātou, Grant, manawatia, amatariki talo for lover. Good evening, a very warm welcome to our viewers and here in Aotearoa and across the globe. On both sides, coming off some dominating first round performances, and we are certainly in for another thrilling test match between these two proud nations.
Yes, these two teams played twice last year, a win apiece, and it's time to look at the two teams for tonight. And well established now is the All Blacks starting loose head prop Ethan de Groot and the entrenched and experienced Frans Malherbe. A 78th test tonight for Cody Taylor at hooker, Bongi Imanumbi for the box. Another great front row battle, Tyrell Lomax and Stephen Kitsoff, who played last week in Pretoria. Two of the very best in the middle row, Brody Retallick and the South African captain, Eben Etzebeth. No Sam Whitelock, and so Scott Barrett wears number five, Lute de Jager for the Springboks. A clash of big bodies on the blind side, Shannon Frizzell for the All Blacks, Franco Mostert for the box. Sam Kane captains the All Blacks for the 21st time in a test. Quagga Smith, open side for the visitors, while in the boot of the scrums, Arnie Savia and the abrasive Jasper Visa.
Oh, plenty of test match experience between these two fine players. The direction of voice crucial tonight for their teams, Aaron Smith and Faf de Klerk. Richard Mwonga and Damien Willemse get the nod in the director's seat, a hotly contested position for both countries. Mark Talia starts his first test of the year, his battle against the elusive Chelson Colby, who he wants to keep an eye on. The powerful and composed Damien Delendi matches up with Jordy Barrett in his 50th test tonight. Lucano Arm and Rico Ioane capable of lighting things up in the midfield on attack. And it's a return for Will Jordan after missing the first week from injury. Magazoli Mpimpi, his opposite. World class to round things off for both teams, Willie LaRue and Bowden Barrett at the back. And plenty of firepower down the bench too. Kia ora to you, Jeff Wilson.
Talofa Mills, tēnā koe, Grant. Kia ora koutou katoa. Plenty of impact off the bench for both sides. The Springboks once again using a 6-forward, 2-back split. The All Blacks, the traditional 5-3, possible debut for Tamaiti Williams off the bench. But no more damaging players in world rugby than the two reserve hookers, Samisone Tokioha and Malcolm Marks. Well, Go Media Stadium in Auckland in excellent conditions. The rain around the city continues to linger, not yet become a factor. The atmosphere electric, and this great rugby rivalry, it continues.
Thank you, Jeff. Well, the Springboks, of course, started their rugby championship convincingly last week in Pretoria by beating the Wallabies by 43 points to 12. But a number of the players that you'll see tonight weren't in Pretoria. They were an advance party. They were convincing with their 6 tries and only conceding 3 penalties throughout the 80 minutes of that competition. And out comes Eben Etzebeth, an emotional night for him, having lost his father, Harry, during the week. And a really brave, courageous decision to stay on and captain the Springboks. And in the continued absence of Andre Pollard, the Springboks tonight hand the number 10 shirt to Damien Willemse. Last year, the versatile Willemse played at fullback in the test against the All Blacks and was quite outstanding in that role. And that ability to play both positions will be invaluable at the upcoming Rugby World Cup. So the Springboks are out there to be joined now by the All Blacks, who were just as convincing against Argentina. Ride with injury in recent times for Will Jordan, and after missing last week in Mendoza, back tonight for the All Blacks. Since his debut against Australia in 2020, Jordan has been a try-scoring machine, dotting down 21 times in 21 test matches, but only once against the Springboks. So the teams are out there standing by now for the anthems.
The South African national anthem will be performed tonight by Kashia Posa, followed by the New Zealand national anthem performed by Teeks. Please stand if you are able.
Magnificent and emotional. Kashia Posa and Teeks with the respective national anthems of New Zealand and South Africa. And now the two teams will line up for the haka prior to the 104th clash between these two great rugby nations. big night. Victor Mighty Williams joining the haka for the first time, led by Aaron Smith. The challenge has been set down, and you can guarantee the Springboks will pick it up. Okay, the match officials, Mathieu Reynal of France, joined by compatriot Pierre Brousset, Angus Gardner, and Ben Whitehouse of Wales, is the TMO. Mathieu Reynal has refereed the All Blacks in recent times, part of the controversy in Melbourne last year involving Bernard Foley, and also the draw in London between the All Blacks and England. Yes, it's not a great record. And it's not very good in Auckland, mind you. No international team has a record that's much good in Auckland. Mark Talia waits. And Evan Entebbe leading the Springboks tonight in the absence of Sia Khaleesi. The countdown is on and the test match is underway. As Willemse kicks off and Talia lines it up, and the All Blacks will run it inside their 22 and look for the clearance as Smith sends it across to Frizzell. And now the clearing kick will come in the form of Bowden Barrett, and he makes good contact down inside Springbok territory. Back now for Visa, big powerful number eight, and away it goes from de Klerk. And it will be physical, but there was a knock-on early.
Great start from the All Blacks, nice and composed. Got themselves sort of plenty of energy and fire in the haka. But it was a good exit, nice few carries from their big men up front, and Richie Mo'unga. He had to make a huge tackle and force that mistake.
The start going to be so critical in this game for both sides, controlling territory, controlling possession. Both teams will want to play the game in the right part of the field, but it starts at scrum time, this enormous battle up front, and this is the first test for both sides.
Yes, the all-important first scrum. Bridge.
Bind.
Yes.
Set.
Yes.
Smith rolls it in. Scrums both holding well. Away for Mo'unga. Now the left-footed boot from Jordy Barrett. And heading back inside his 22 is Billy LaRue. And he makes really good contact. Mo'unga looks to go quickly, does so. And now the All Blacks looking to counter-attack through Will Jordan. Ball knocked down and went back. And it snapped up for a Retallick. As the All Blacks rampage inside Springbok territory. Carried on, here's Frizzell into the clear. What a great run. Now looking for quick ball, Aaron Smith slings it away for Mo'unga. Rekko Ioane stumbled and fell, but then got up and went again. Away it goes forward to Groot. All Blacks attacking strongly. Good start to the game. 2 minutes gone. De Groot tries to release, does so now. Now Mo'unga away for Scott Barrett. Didn't find his man. Ball intercepted by the Springboks. And now de Klerk clears it off downfield. Bouncing the ball will be interesting. Bearing down quickly here is Mapimpi. But now Talia looks to get away. Mark Talia, oh, thumping tackle by Entebbe, the captain. What a start to this game. Scott Barrett. 10 out from the 22. And now Smith, as the All Blacks look to settle it. Frizzell already won stampeding run in the game. Smith again. Back for Mo'unga. Almost challenged and charged by Entebbe. Taken down by Jordan. Immediately gets it off to Mo'unga. Lays it on the ground. And now the All Blacks come again through Retallick. long period of play here as Smith away from Moanga again. Here is once again Frizzell. Smith quick hands. Moanga accelerates nicely. Still on their own side of halfway though. Quick hands, lovely. Now Kane got it away to Talia. Ball there for Smith again. Game being played at high speed. Cody Taylor lays it up. Referee's got the arm out. Offside against the Springboks. Here's Frizzell. What a start he's had. Smith again. Slings it off to Kane. Still playing under this penalty advantage. Smith again. Now Scott Barrett. All Blacks asking a lot of questions early in this match. Short pass for Mark Talia. Ball becomes available again for Smith. Now to Groot. Away for Moanga. Bowden Barrett goes wide. Lovely pass to Jordan. Almost broke the tackle. Then he went again. Well, Jordan. Oh, my goodness. Aaron Smith. Unbelievable.
Vintage. And absolutely vintage from the All Blacks. Nice and composed. I tell you what. Less than 5 minutes into this game, the intensity, she's hot, all right. Showed plenty of endeavour to the All Blacks. They got in the front foot. Is an excellent pass here by Barrett out wide. But watch the work on Willie LaRue. Nice tackle. But the nous of Will Jordan releases the ball back in on the inside to Aaron Smith. First try to the All Blacks. Wow.
What a remarkable start to this game. A long period of play back and forward, but it was the All Blacks who got multiple phases, and the fractured defence from the Springboks was found wanting, and the impact of Will Jordan. The delivery to Aaron Smith, the first try. What a start.
What a start, all right. Richie Moanga converts. 7-0. And the brilliance of Will Jordan. And Aaron Smith scampers in for try number 25 in Test Rugby. And what a big one that is. The ball in play for just over 3 minutes after that one and only scrum. Everybody was exhausted. Phillipson gets us going again. Talia waits again inside the 22. And makes good ground too, Mark Talia. Has that ability to break tackles, and that'll be a penalty. And I think you call that lazy running.
Yeah, I love the work of the All Blacks earlier on. They're really winning the contact. Some of their backs using some nice bit of footwork, but they're getting well and truly over the game line. The speed of the ruck, Jeff, has been outstanding in these first 6.5 minutes.
Well, if you get beyond the game line, all of a sudden all the players are offside. They have to retire, and if your clean-out's fast and in good technique, you're getting fast ball. And when you look at that, it's a part of the game. The All Blacks have had plenty of practice at Art Jatina on the line-out. They'll look to strike again.
Cody Taylor, Retallick, unchallenged as they move inside Springbok territory. 7 minutes gone on the test, and the All Blacks get another penalty. Pulling them all down. And no thought given to a shot at goal here. The All Blacks want to advance themselves deep into Springbok territory through Geordie Barrett.
It's just been such a frenetic start from the All Blacks. The skill level's up. You can see why the Springboks are now just trying to win that momentum back. Slow the ball down and really try and get some shoulders on defence.
Once again, they go to Retallick. Once again, they hold it. Now Kane comes away. Gives it off to Smith, who was stumbling as he took the pass, but he held on well. So Frizzell goes to the back of the maul. What an impact he's made early. Now up the middle goes Savia. Ball is there on the 22 for Smith. Retallick at first receiver. Ball becomes available. Kane lost it behind him. Oh, another penalty. The Springboks getting hit early in the penalty count. They only conceded three in the whole game last week. They've already conceded three.
And piggybacking some penalties in there. The All Blacks, it's interesting to see their big runners really shoring up there. You see Retallick here's nice and close. He's got a connection there with Barrett. Really making sure they do a big effort on that first threat that gets over the ball. And they're doing some good work at the moment, Jeff.
Yeah, they've come out of the gates fast, have the All Blacks. And in line-out time, what they are giving up is the front, the Springboks, and the All Blacks are going to it to guarantee possession. Can't quite launch off that, but you can retain possession, and that's been their biggest ally in the first 9 minutes. They've had the ball in their hands, and they've looked very good carrying it into contact.
Right out in front, Richie Mwanga. And through it goes. 10 points in less than 10 minutes. Willemsen, once again. This time it's Jordy Barrett, calling for it. And decides to head off downfield, almost to the 22. Now here's Frizzell off the Smith pass.
Get ready.
Still inside the 22, so they can clear for touch. And the kick is across by Bowden Barrett. Wasn't looking for the touchline, and it's been lost forward by Mapimpi. And it's all running the All Blacks' way in the early stages.
I like the early stages from the All Blacks. The game plan, obviously, not to be able to kick the ball out because you're going to give that back to the Springboks to launch off a line-out. We're going to be very, very strong. But it's also complemented by guys chasing. Have a look at the pressure there from Will Jordan. All the momentum for the All Blacks right now, but their settled game plan is absolutely working.
Just the accuracy. Just keep an eye on the contacts and carry. We have the Springboks aren't able to get a contact up high, Mills. Everything's around the legs, which means the All Black carry is going forward. And they're not just running into bodies, they're running into spaces. And there's been some really nice footwork, particularly from Frizzell early on, which has enabled them to give themselves time to exit and to kick accurately.
Totally agree. And the placement of that ball too, it's right out. Frizzell, he's been epic. He has taken the outside channel as well, so a little bit more lateral, but he's shown a bit of power when need be.
Right foot on the mark, please, or left to the mark. Yeah, not too far away.
All Blacks running at 92% possession. The Springboks have had little or no ball.
Stretch! Bye! Set!
All Blacks holding, looking to put some pressure on and getting another penalty.
The underground.
That's four.
The first thing, freeze man, you've got the boss knee on the ground. Then you get up at first at the beginning.
Oh, he's gone for a knee on the ground. And this is alarming stuff for South Africa. Because that's a big part of their game, their scrum, trying to get themselves their hands on the ball to try and launch for the All Blacks. It's another easy out, Jeff, and a chance to really keep establishing and carry on that momentum from this game plan of the year.
And it's Tyrell Lomax on the far side that's done the damage. The knee's gone down on the far side, the call from assistant referee. But Tyrell Lomax, one of the big movers last year for the All Blacks, has started strongly again.
12 minutes gone. All Blacks go short. De Groot away to Smith. Now Mwanga to Jordy Barrett in midfield. He'll take it up strongly. Smith punching high. Waiting is Mapimpi. Oh, the All Blacks almost grabbed it. Ioane stretching through. But I think they've lost it forward.
Okay.
Wow, what a kick that was.
Ben.
But it
just
did look very much as if the All Blacks had lost it forward.
Knock on Black.
I don't know you, mate.
On knock field, on Black. Knock
on field decision, knock on. You confirm it? Okay, thank you.
Yes.
interesting, isn't it? A tactic from the All Blacks, knocked on here, being called Will Jordan, wins the battle in the air. But it's obviously an area where the All Blacks feel they can put real heat on, and that's that kicking game, but the ability of some of their wingers to get up and really contest.
Well, that commitment to the air, the length of the kick was perfect. And it was a great strength of Ben Smith, who was on the right-hand wing for the All Blacks. And already Will Jordan being prepared to get up, contest possession, and look where the Springboks are now having to work their way out of. They've just conceded a scrum penalty. Important here, the All Blacks, though. They don't give anything away.
First scrum put in for the Springboks, but they're deep in their own 22. So, back to clear. Scrum holds. No one's going anywhere here. So, Declare goes for a bit of a scamper. Gets it off to LaRue. And that's a good, powerful punt by Vivi LaRue. And takes play down to halfway. And an excellent exit from the Springboks.
Very nice there. Sorry, from LaRue. Love the clerk as well. Some experience in this back line.
So far, the All Blacks have gone to Retallick in the lineouts. This time, stretching is Barrett. Brings it in nicely. Carried up by Savia to halfway. There it is for Smith. Mwanga standing directly behind him. This will come down on the 10-metre line. And Talia got a hand on that, knocked it back. Now Bowden Barrett goes with a wipers kick for Jordan again. Gets support. Now back on the inside for Bowden Barrett. All Blacks keeping the ball alive. Judge couldn't make the transfer. Talia, though, has support now from Retallick. All Blacks playing at high speed as Talia takes it in. Springboks having to make a mountain of tackles early. A little jab through, the bounce falls up for Bowden Barrett. Slips it away to Kane. All Blacks still in possession. Now it's coming again for Aaron Smith. Running hard as it will Jordan once more. Pops it out to Taylor. There is Frizzell. Frizzell! Oh my goodness! All Blacks on fire.
There's one man that deserves a try. I'll tell you what, that's this man here. Shannon Frizzell. He has been an absolute beast mode in these early minutes of this game. But how about Will Jordan? Spots a little wee hole. The All Blacks, a nice little ball wide. Frizzell down that sideline. Willie LaRue sit down. Great try, the All Blacks.
Remarkable play, and it's that man Will Jordan again. Gets his hands on the ball. Spots a gap on the inside. Taylor times it beautifully, and Frizzell, boom, over the top try.
What a start this has been. Sam Kane was down for some time, but he's back, he's okay. And the All Blacks have put two tries on the Springboks in the first 15 minutes.
Just in sideline here, it's almost like the crowd are in shock. It's been that good from the All Blacks, and the Springboks just reeling at the moment.
So here he is from the sideline. What a good kick that is. 17 points to nil, and I think everybody's in shock. Talk about the coming of age of Shannon Frizzell. The story of the match, 93% possession for the All Blacks as it goes down for Talia. Simply running rings around the box at the moment. Now Bowden Barrett away for Mwanga.
bit of space again for Jordan. This time, Mapimpi is able to make the tackle. Retallick inside the 22 still. Now Smith looking to do the clearing himself. And it's drifting into touch. Springboks wants a ball. Oh, that's horrible. That's terrible. Wasn't Jasper Visa's fault. It was a poor pass.
Yeah, and I think Visa would have wanted them just to calm things down and just wait and just get a line out.
I get the sense this is what scoreboard pressure does, doesn't it, Mills? When you're behind by 17, you start thinking you have to start playing, maybe away from your game. A quick throw in for them is probably not their first choice, getting a launch.
So just let me know, after I blow the whistle for the knock-on, there is an eye tackle by Black. Okay, so the full play of the decision.
Correct.
Captain, please. After I blow the whistle, there is an eye tackle by Black. So we say on the foul play, it's a penalty kick against.
So the Springboks finish up with their first penalty of the game.
No, it is definitely needed here. They dodged the bullet there to the Springboks, a high tackle they've come back for. Dangerous play. Good chance now to really get themselves settled, pin the corner. And I'm sure Jeff will want to try and get to a driving line out.
Yeah, they'll go to their strength. Just watch it here. Just comes in, and no doubt Shannon Frizzell just comes over the top of the shoulder.
Here you are.
Faf de Klerk asking for it. Mistake from Frizzell, but it's only his first one of the game. He's been remarkable.
Mbanambi to throw for the Springboks. Line out won by Diaga. Here's their first real opportunity. Dialende charges up. Now de Klerk. Good strong defence by the All Blacks. De Klerk away for Kitsoff. Almost to the 22. And the ball pops up and another penalty.
And that's that man again.
Absolutely on fire tonight, Shannon Frizzell.
Good power there, didn't he? There's a ruck before this. Springboks very guilty of just going a little bit too lateral, which slowed that ball around. Couldn't quite get wide enough and allowed Shannon Frizzell to get a really nice hit.
Quarter of the way through this game as Retallick wins the line out. Mwanga away into midfield for Geordie Barrett.
Backwards.
Powerful take up and Lomax tidies up. Now Taylor emerges with the ball. Five in the Springbok on the Springbok side of halfway and up the middle goes Ioane. And the Springboks piling into this. And they get a reward too. Now Lukanya Arm. Haven't had much ball. They make it to halfway. Now De Klerk. Look at the tackling by the All Blacks. Now Diaga. De Klerk waits. Away it goes for Billy LaRue. Now Dialende. Pops the pass for Mapimpi. Well contained on the 10-meter line. De Klerk goes blindside. And he got it back too. And he's back in position. Now Mbanambi threatening to make it to the 22. Vilimsa away for Kitsoff. Ball available for de Klerk. Now Vilimsa away for Cheslin Colby. He's got plenty of pace. Almost to the 22 again. Now LaRue, Vilimsa gets it across for Mostert. Putting some good moves together here, the Springboks, as Diaga takes it in. Now de Klerk, here's LaRue, looks on the inside for Colby.
advantage.
And they get a penalty too. His arm frees it up. Now D'Alende. Smashing tackle by Taylor. As the All Blacks pile over the top. And they'll have to go back for the penalty.
One here for off.
Boy, it's physical.
Jeez, what? Really nice here from the Springboks because they're just getting some nice momentum. Haven't had a lot of the ball. So trying to get things on their own terms once again. Some big ball carriers winning their ruck, but equal to the task are the All Blacks on defence as well, Jeff.
The All Blacks determined to keep coming forward, try and stop him in momentum, but that was comfortably the best period of play for the Springboks. And that man, Faf de Klerk, just sniping down the short side, making some good ground, keeping the ball alive. It was really nicely done. Good counter ruck. If you fall off at the breakdown, they can get the ball back very, very quickly. The All Blacks tried to regroup, but the Springboks held on to possession, built some pressure, earned a penalty. Significant moment in this test match for them right now.
So, Imbanambi, up goes Etzebeth. Now the Springboks. Slip it to the back of the maul, but going nowhere at the moment. Imbanambi looks around, edging forward. Now he has to fire it back in Pimpy, but he gets nailed by Retallick. And the All Blacks have come away, but they've knocked it on.
Knock on Black.
So the Springboks have a scrum deep inside the 22.
Here is the mark, guys. Time off.
Oh, we're very privileged to go downstairs now and have Sam Whitelock join us. Sam, you couldn't have asked for a better start from these guys in black.
Yeah, the boys have been awesome. They've stepped up. Their physicality is right there, as we always know. We need to be in that space against the good South African side.
Talk us through that physicality, because the breakdown, you're absolutely winning those moments. The speed of the ruck has been really quick. What are the focuses for those guys throughout this week to try and get that fast ball?
Exactly that. We've got to be there nice and early. They've got a number of ball threats that can get over the wall and punish us if we're slow. So first thing's getting there fast, but then obviously eyes up, seeing the threats that are coming, and make sure you're one bullet, one man, you know, do the job there.
You haven't had to tackle too many times, but when you have, you show plenty of physicality. You must be pretty happy with that too.
Yeah, it's something that we've addressing constantly. You know, last week I thought we took a good step, and then obviously the boys are finding pretty well at the moment, so we've just got to keep doing that and keep trusting our skill set to get in their face and hopefully cause some turnovers.
Thank you very much for your time, Sam. Awesome. Really appreciate it. Set.
So, play resumes.
You weren't up too strong and you destabilize the... Okay? So be careful with that.
Lots of reset. Check going on at the moment. The Springbok back line. Arms come in. Hardly seen him so far. He's a very dangerous player. Willemse. They're in a good part of the field. First swing through. They know they can get around that corner. It's the ability possibly to go between Moonga and Jordan there. It's a nice hole there. Very, very shallow setup. Look at those three there from the Springboks. The advantage line will be the key for them.
So, de Klerk to get it in. All Blacks holding well, looking to pressure now. De Klerk gets it off. D'Alende takes it straight ahead. Quick hands away for Visa. Met in a solid tackle by Retallick. Now away for Diaga. There it is again for Faf de Klerk. Up for Imbanambi. Now Mostert, 5 metres away, slips it off to the captain. Now looking to be a little more expansive, Willemse, dragged down by Ioane. De Klerk again, up for Visa, came back in the tackle. De Klerk with the kick, Kobe! He's claiming it against Beauden Barrett. It looked as though Beauden Barrett
I couldn't hear a mark called, so I think we have to play on there. So we just need to then check who grounded it first.
OK.
I'm not sure
I have no idea about who grounded it first.
OK. We'll have to double-check that.
Yeah. Fiamma, Ben?
Yes, mate. Go on.
Yeah, we have no idea about who grounded the ball first. So can you put it on the screen, please?
Yes, I can, Matthew. First of all, the player's clearly onside. We'll move on to the grounder.
It here, he gets it stripped off him. It's whether Colby gets that ball down with his right hand.
The other screen will be.
Well, has it come off Colby's hand? I'm not sure it has.
Oh, dear.
We just need to see if he presses the ball, Matthew. Hang on.
Okay.
They're just looking at grounding.
Yeah. And whether he's got control of that grounding, I think, is what they're looking at.
So here, at any stage, doesn't look as though Beauden Barrett gets a... He doesn't get a hand on it.
This is a really tough call.
Is that a knock-on or a grounding? That's such a hard call.
Sorry, Matthew, this is really tight.
OK, we wait for you, mate, because on the screen we don't see clearly if there is a separation with the ball, yes or no.
Yeah, okay, Matthew, hang on.
Does it bounce off the hand here? This is a 50-50 call.
It comes off his knee. It's this hand here.
But has that bounced off his hand?
Okay, Matthew, I have a decision.
Yeah?
It's no try. The ball is not grounded.
No try, ball is not
grounded.
Yeah,
he does not press the ball down.
Not, okay, so we restart by...
Knock on in goal.
Knock on in goal, so goal line drop out.
Yes.
Right?
Well,
no try.
The Springboks.
No,
the Springboks thought
goal,
they'd scored. They went all the way back inside their own territory.
Knock on in goal, goal line drop out. Wait. Okay.
Goal line dropout from Geordie Barrett, and he thumps it 60 metres down. Oh no! That's a knock on for sure. Nothing going right for the Springboks. And on this occasion, totally the architects of their own undoing. Damien Dalende, experienced player.
Uncharacteristic too from him. Look at that. And that's just pressure. They've just been shell-shocked. Richard Moonga is obviously possibly claiming that it moved a bit in the air. She's all been the All Black so far.
You keep closer,
in the first half.
Go out.
And this time de Klerk does a job on Smith.
Ground, so he can be tackled.
And the Springboks secure a turnover. And the kick downfield by de Klerk, but it bounces into touch. Colby was after it, read it well.
A mistake from the All Blacks at the back of the scrum. Goes down the wrong channel. Adi Savia misses it. And they replay quickly.
And away it goes for Adi Savia, standing out at first receiver. Now Smith works it away for Zell. Now Retallick into a half gap. De Groot sends it off to Mwanga. Another midfield bomb. Springboks haven't handled these well, and once again it falls away. Been grabbed by Barrett. And the chase coming from Cody Taylor. But it's going to be forced by Cheslin Colby. Well, the Springboks thought there might have been a knock-on here. And they might have had a point.
Yeah, I think it came off Will Jordan's hands here. Lee LaRue missing it completely.
So the goal line dropout from Damien Phillipson. Barrett went 60 metres with him. Phillipson a little more modest as Savia takes it into contact right in centre field. And an All Black player charging in over the top. And it might have been Frizzell who is penalised. And so a little respite here for the box.
Yeah, Stephen Kitsoff getting over that ball. He just missed that clean out. So Mike Lockman mentioned it before, one man, one bullet. And the big man.
Just watch here, Artie Savia gets the ground and then Kitsoff's over the ball. Sam Kane wasn't able to move the body. And holding on. Frizzell a little bit late. Good work, but this is a critical 10 minutes for the Springboks in the context of this test match just missing out on a try. You get the sense they need to strike before half-time, and they're quite capable.
In. Getting to the line-out very slowly. Mbonambi throws. Retallick turns the ball over. Talia away for Mwonga. Geordie Barrett, an almighty thump downfield. Oh, lovely hands, Billy LaRue. That was swirling, and he took it nicely. And just stayed inside the 22, I think. Boy, it was marginal.
Nicely done there by Retallick.
Go. All Blacks challenging at Springbok line-out time.
Step off the mark. You step off the mark.
Well, you don't want to test the patience of Matthew Reynal. Just ask Bernard Foley.
Well, it's a hard one because the All Blacks are looking for space, but the Springboks just crept a little bit, so the All Blacks backed off. And like you say, the patience tested.
Sorry, I told you.
It'll be disappointment.
I told you that in the changing room, I make gap.
Jason Ryan's looking at the video footage, going, look at that. We stepped up, they did that. The Springbok coaching team, they need some answers, and they need them quickly.
Stretch!
Springboks edging forward. First sign of any scrum dominance. They've got a penalty coming their way if they need it. Now the ball shoveled out as far as Colby out on the right wing side. Dragged down in the tackle of Ioane. Charging hard as Visa. Ball coming. No, it's not. It's been turned over. Quick hands. Oh, nice work, Retallick. Wasn't expecting it. Still inside the All Black territory as Smith sends it away for Bowden Barrett. Now Geordie with a kick pass. Jordan smacks it hard. Has he kept it in? No. So back they go. All Blacks on the back foot.
A good win over the ball here. said Kane getting over. The Springboks advantage was over. And would have wanted them back. So they're in a good position mentally for the Springboks. They want to get themselves back into the game, but they haven't had it their own way. They haven't been able to go to their strengths, their lineouts, their scrums. So they've had to try and play in a more expansive game. But in doing that too, there's a lot of risk because the All Blacks are getting over the ball like Sam Kane did in that situation.
Mbanambi finding Mostert, and the Springboks through de Klerk make good ground. Dalende gets in there. Up it goes for Diaga, Ludiaga. Oh, loose ball. That has been snapped up by Taylor. Untidy play from the box, but they've got a penalty out of it as the All Blacks didn't release.
Two play on fit.
Well, one would imagine they'll again look to the touchline here. Oh, what? I think it's 17-0 down. Oh, no, no. Shot at goal coming up.
That's a big win for the All Blacks too, because their defence has been really good around the ruck area, really honing in on that, just making it really messy. Taylor here just guilty of losing his feet. He had fought too long. And the Springboks getting over it. I think this is a sensible play for the Springboks, Jeff, just to get some points, some confidence back in their team.
Yeah, they probably deserve some points out of the first half now. They've been in the right part of the field. They've turned down a couple of shots at goal, and just to close the gap, just to settle it down. And we've just seen the scrum starting to get a little bit of momentum, and the breakdown effort from them is getting some reward.
Well, he's kicked before, but not very often. Faf de Klerk. And through it goes, and the Springboks finally on the board just before half time, as the All Blacks lead by 17-3. The restart from Bowden Barrett, and nobody manages to claim it. Finally, it was Kane who gave it off to Smith. Now here's opening up for Bowden Barrett. Got it away for Retallick. Now Scott Barrett. And clever play by Aaron Smith. He's been around a while, this boy. 116th test. And he saw a Springbok coming back. The referee had no option. He had to give the penalty to the All Blacks.
I really love the reload as well from the All Blacks there, because it was an opportunity. Whilst he milked that penalty, they had numbers down that blind side. Great work. There's a couple of holes there that they're starting to find. The up-tempo play from the All Blacks. Here it is here. And a shot at goal for Richie Moonga.
That was nice from Bowden Barrett too. He was prepared to aggressively take it back to the line. And when the All Blacks have managed to offload and keep the ball alive, that's when they've been able to really stress the defence. You see the number of points for Richie Moonga. It's really in the last couple of seasons he's tried to cement himself as that All Black first five. And it's been a really positive start for him in this test match. And for the All Blacks to get the three back immediately would be a big moment.
So, Moonga hits it nicely, and the All Blacks strike back immediately with another penalty goal. 20-3. Willemsa from halfway. A little shorter this time. Barrett goes high, couldn't pull it in. Grabbed by Geordie Barrett. Now Talia.
Taking back in.
Smith away for Frizzell. Yeah, now Smith once more.
Great.
Bowden Barrett. Again, not looking for the touchline. Jordan coming through quickly. But terrific work this time by Mapimpi. De Klerk waiting back is Bowden Barrett. And as he's challenged by Willemsa, he gets it into Springbok territory where De Klerk hands it off for LaRue. Colby looks to get on the outside. Taylor chased and got him. All Blacks putting plenty of pressure on at ruck time as LaRue away for Kitsoff. Still five in All Black territory. De Klerk again. LaRue stayed in close to the action. Dialende. Now Mapimpi, try scorer against the All Blacks last year. Grabbed by Imbanambi. Here's Visa. Running hard and straight as always. Now De Klerk. Away for Lacanya Arm. Taken solidly by Frizzell. Here is Mapimpi. Everybody wanting to get involved. Last minute of the first half as LaRue away for Mostert. Ball is there again for De Klerk. Now Visa running hard into a gap. A little bit isolated for the moment. But the ball presented to Faf De Klerk. Billy LaRue. Lacanya Arm. Now Mapimpi once more. Smashed in the tackle on the 22. De Klerk goes again. LaRue for Etzebeth. Big build up here from the Springboks. Can they convert it into points though? Mapimpi stepping his way through a few. Tried to offload. Held on in the finish. Now De Klerk. Away for Kitsoff. Arm. Mapimpi. Head high tackle. So now the Springboks have a penalty advantage. Let's see what they do here in the last act of the first half.
Just give you some nice momentum. Interesting to see Willie LaRue stepping up into that first receiver role and then letting Damien Willemsa get a little bit wide, show us a little bit of a footwork. He cut back in on that inside channel, but really trying to free him up as well. And just a head-high tackle from Telea.
Yeah, over the shoulder. They've gone to the line-out, Mills. Big moment for the All Blacks.
Yes, big defensive effort required here. Imbanambi to throw. Taken by Diaga. Now the pressure coming on. Imbanambi. Slow progress, but it's progress. Going to have to go, and he does, Imbanambi. Now De Klerk. Away for Mostert. De Klerk again, they're lining up, Etzebeth. Goes hard, Frizzell puts him down. De Klerk again, Visa. De Klerk once more. Almost through. De Klerk once more. Franco Mostert. Desperate times here. Etzebeth! Etzebeth! Almost. Held up close. And it won't come back. The All Blacks have defended this. Oh, he wants to have a look. He wants to have a look.
Ben. I just want to check here. I think he's held up, but I'm not sure about if there is a grounding, yes or no. Can you please check? I don't have an idea. If there is a grounding, yes or no, by the green.
Matthew, we don't need to check the grounding. We have a neck roll in the middle of the field on the 5 meter line by five green. Five green.
So
a
knock
roll.
On by five
where
green.
You are on the 5 meter line.
Okay, knock on.
Yes.
So, and oh.
Neck roll.
Neck roll. Neck roll.
Neck roll.
Okay,
yes.
Neck roll.
Five
green neck roll here. So penalty yes, kick against the five green.
Five green.
Five green neck roll, penalty kick.
Well, that's the end of that. A neck roll from Lidiaga. And so the All Blacks get a penalty. They'll kick it out, and that'll be it.
Yeah, it is.
He is too, yeah.
Great work from Artie Sarvia. Stayed in the fight.
So the ball is duly kicked into touch. And that is a memorable first 40 minutes here at Mount Smart Stadium. And the All Blacks go to the break with a lead of 20 points to 3. The Rugby Championship from Go Media, Mount Smart Stadium, and the All Blacks dominant in the first half, 20 points to 3. Let's go to the dressing rooms now. Jeff Wilson with the respective assistant coaches. Firstly, from South Africa, Wandile Stick.
Well, clearly, what were the messages at halftime?
We just need to be clinical, you know. We're making a lot of unforced errors, and then that brings the All Blacks into the game. We saw they started very well. They capitalized from the position, converted into quick points, you know, and now we're trying to chase the game, and we're making more errors. So I think we just need to be calm down a bit and then make sure that we keep our ball in hand, and then make sure that we convert also into points a couple of times on a 22.
Good luck, stick it out.
Cheers, thanks.
The first 20 minutes, what have you talked about at halftime?
Yeah, just keeping that tempo, Goldie. We put them under some good pressure there, but we felt we fell away there, so got to keep that up.
Let's talk about the reserves coming on and making an impact. What's the message to the team?
Just do your job and bring that tempo that we talked about, and not try and do anything on your own. Just work as a good team.
What are you expecting from the Springboks?
Oh, they're not going to go away. They're a class outfit, and they'll be in for 80.
Thanks, mate.
Cheers.
There we are, the words from the dressing room. Now, a significant change here. There's Dalton Papali'i out there. Sam Kane has retired injured, which means that Artie Sarvia has taken over as the All Black captain. Let's go back and see the injury for Kane. And here he is. Gets himself in a very awkward position. See the grimace. And he was attended to, Sam Kane, but unfortunately, he's had to leave the game at halftime. Springboks unchanged, but you'd imagine, Mills, that the bomb squad will be on fairly early.
Yeah, absolutely they will. They'll be trying to get that momentum back. 20 points to 3 down. And really trying to implement their game. And try and do the same as what the All Blacks did to them in the first half. Shell shocked them.
Okay, we're ready to go. Second half as Bowden Barrett makes the kickoff, and the Springboks through Jasper Visser take it outside the 22. Faf de Klerk. Ball touched by an All Black, and it's heading down for Mwanga. Immediately releases, and off goes Bowden Barrett. Mwanga again. Jordan, one of the standout players in that first half, fires it across for Taylor, and Cody Taylor sets it just on the All Blacks side of halfway. Smith punching down. Wonderful work by Talia. Delivers into midfield. Mwanga takes it on the fly. Then lets rip with a lovely kick. Sarvia's charging hard. And another good start for the All Blacks.
Now, they're just continuing that aerial game, aren't they? Getting up in the air. The wingers chasing well. J-line getting it back. Mwanga, excellent decision.
And Mbonambi throws. Nobody really jumped. That's a wild pass away for Dalende. Right out in front of his own goalpost here. Now, De Klerk. Back for Willemsa. The clearing kick is made.
Down
just over the 22. So just repeating there that Dalton Papali'i is on the field. Sam Kane is out of the game. Adi Savia is the All Black captain. Taylor with the throw. Again, Retallick. Dominant line-out performance in the first half. Good momentum going here too as Taylor takes them over the 22. Now Smith releases. Inside pass. Jordan in the clear again. Just couldn't get the pass away and the ball's gone loose. Been lost forward though by the All Blacks. And now the whistle goes that, oh, Will Jordan, he is a match winner for sure.
Oh, there's no substitute really for speed. Nice little hole on that inside because all the forwards had to get into that rolling more that the All Blacks implemented. They've done it so well, Jed, taking the front ball, but they've been so efficient in the way they've marched in about it and created that hole for Will Jordan.
Just that awareness, and they're going to go. You talk about going to their bench at what stage, Grant Nisbet? Well, it's happened early. They've waited a whole 3 minutes before we're going to see Malcolm Marks. And Aji Sneyman comes on as well. And we know how impactful Marks can be in the game. Just wait to see who's coming off for the Springboks. Clearly, it's going to be Mongi Mbanambi and Luke Diaga.
Sure.
Talk about that awareness from Will Jordan. The threat through the middle of the park with speed, isolating forwards, accelerating the gaps, and he was just looking to offload to Richie Mo'onga, who was in support, but the contact came through his arms and he lost it forward. But critically, Mills, the All Blacks playing the first period in the second half in the right part of the field.
Oh, just love the way they've gone about it. That line-out draw from the front ball. All the forwards had to gravitate there to try and help the Springboks, but then it opened it up. Geordie Barrett running it forward. There's a nice hole on that inside using Will Jordan. Just efficient in the moment out of the All Blacks.
So the changes have been made by the Springboks. Malcolm Marks and RG Sneyman are on the park. Has to use it. All Blacks packing a very solid scrum tonight. Away it goes for Vinny LaRue. And a good searching kick away downfield by LaRue. Takes play almost to halfway.
Seven green.
Another change coming here. Seven.
Franco Mostert replaced by Peter Steff.
Time back on.
Boy, there's some size on. Coming on now as the bomb squad is starting to be released. Taylor to throw. Barrett wins the line out. Mo'onga. Hard charge by Geordie Barrett in midfield. Now Retallick, quick hands. No advantage play. As Fafta Klug clearly knocks it on.
The Klug read that well because the All Blacks were setting up something very, very shallow in the initial setup over the top. He had to come off his line, try and stop that ball over the top to Frizzell.
Really enthusiastic crowd here tonight. Springboks have got a mountain of support. 20 points to 3. Now Aaron Smith away for Mo'onga. Again, it's Barrett running hard. Ball released from Frizzell across for Scott Barrett. As the All Blacks keep it going in the same direction, Savia gets a bad pass and knocked it on. And at the moment, just moving from one scrum to the next, and time for another change for the Springboks, Jeff.
It's Wayne Vermeulen, all of his experience coming on. To see where the replacement, Jasper Visser is the replacement, or the replaced player. So they're going to all of their size.
Well, it looks like the Italian women's football team are in the audience tonight. Of course, the Women's World Cup starting on Thursday. Massive tournament throughout New Zealand and Australia. Interestingly, none of the All Blacks are up on the bench at the moment. The Springboks making big changes. Now they put some pressure on, and they get a penalty too. Getting some real oomph out of the bench. As De Klerk away for Schneeman. Now here's Malcolm Marks. De Klerk again slings it away for Willems. Kick through and off the side of the boot. And there was no advantage there going back for a penalty. And it was a dominant Springbok scrum.
Yeah. Their bench already seeing evident while they're coming on and the job they need to do at hand. It's almost a fresh start for them. They know they've got to go out there and win that power game. It's a bit, they're going for the corner.
Just checking out the All Black bench. There's been no movement just yet. Remembering to Mighty Williams. And it looks as though it's been kicked dead, Nisbo.
Oh, dear. Big opportunity. Faf de Klerk has made a real mess of it. And they'll go back for a scrum where he kicked it. Never looked like it, actually.
Didn't it? Yeah, you'll be disappointed with that. You see what he was trying to do right on that 5-metre line. Give those big boys a good chance to get their line out going, their line out drive. And that's a huge mistake, a chance for the All Blacks, really, to try and just get that settled movement back, that momentum, the skill set, bit of movement going on at the moment now, Jeff, by the looks of things.
Yes,
yep, Nipo Lalala.
They're stirring on the bench.
Remembering Samasoni Tokiaho is there as well.
Wait. Yeah. Not too overextended, okay? Stephen, your elbow up. Please, go ahead. In straight, okay, in the scrum.
50th test tonight for Jordy Barrett.
After all the player.
Having a very solid game in midfield.
Okay, thank you. Your feet under your stomach, elbow up, please.
And of course, for a number of All Blacks, this is the penultimate test in New Zealand.
Don't hit that, please.
Before it's bon voyage to the World Cup in France.
Crutch! Bind! Set!
Right, so the reset. Smith. De Klerk about to pounce. Couldn't get him though. Mwanga goes high again. Colby waits and can't control again.
It's okay.
It is okay, says the referee. Now De Klerk. Away for LaRue. Stabbed through by D'Alende. Jordan brings it under control. And the ball loose. Ritali feeds it off to Mwanga. Ioane hasn't seen a lot of ball. Rico Ioane tonight. Smith again. punching it away into Springbok territory is Bowden Barrett. Willemsen. At least it's Mapimpi. Back to Clerk. Sends it off to LaRue. Right out to midfield. Strong run by Peter Steph Dutoit. LaRue. Ball there, back to Clerk. Went down in a heap. Didn't look good either.
We're on the night to have an access to the board.
A man who only lasted a couple of minutes in the series last year when he got knocked cold in Nelspruit. Just the way he fell, didn't look good at all.
Yeah, I think his knee hit one of the All Black players that were on the ground. He just tried to jump over them. Might have collected the head as well as he was trying to get to that ruck.
Time off. Green nine.
Grant Williams is coming on to replace Fafter Klerk. He's gone to ground. So plenty of impact being required off the bench of the Springboks. Things are stirring for the All Blacks. The entire front row is up. Tamaiti Williams, Simisoni Topiaho, and Nimpo Lalala are not far away.
You just wonder whether some of that stink starting to come out of the All Blacks' legs from the excellent start they've had. Losing a little bit of momentum, and also that skill execution just not as clear as what it was in that first half.
So De Klerk leaves the park, replaced by Williams. And in the meantime, Willemsen has punched the ball 15 metres away from the All Black line. So Marks to throw, finding Schneeman. Not going to go anywhere here. The All Blacks trying to disrupt. Now Williams plugs the blind side. He's a lively runner. This time he's shut down though. Now Smith hands it away to Kitsoff. And the All Blacks penalised immediately. And against Brody Retallick.
And on the ground first.
So once again, Willemsen. All Blacks looking to replace, I think, Jeff, the whole front row.
Yeah. I can say they're itching to get out there. And call being that Brody Retallick had just got his hands on the ground before ball.
So Springboks will try again through Marks. Once again, Schneeman goes high. Aaron Smith's concerned about the blind side, but Marks comes to the open side. This is looking pretty good for the Springboks. And they've got the try. Through Malcolm Marks.
Oh, just what the coach had ordered. The impact off the bench, the muscle, the grind. And back to their strength, Malcolm Marks. It was a lobbed ball, which they won nice and secure. Have a look at that left-hand side. Frizzell leaves because he feels there's a real big threat on that blind side. But as they roll around, Malcolm Marks in the back there, jersey 16, they roll. Got a little bit of help, over they go. Great try.
Yeah, they set it up beautifully. There's no team better in the world when they get momentum. They know how to take advantage of it. And they score and territory, and you give them possession. And the impact off the bench, the size up front, and they get the result. The All Blacks have made two changes. Experience comes on, and Simisoni Pukiaho and Nepo Lalala. They have replaced Cody Taylor, and the change at tight head as well in regards to Tyrell Lomax.
Springboks grinding their way back into the game. Conversion is good by Cheslin Colby, and 20 points to 10. Fifteen. 16th test try for Malcolm Marks as Bowden Barrett restarts the game. Taken in by Dutoit. Now Williams waits. Dilimsa sends it wide, looking to open it up. His arm thumps it hard. And this is another good clearance by the Springboks from inside their 22. They've taken it as far as the All Black 10-metre line.
They're doing really well, the Springboks, to take the tempo out of the game. Mills update. They're going from set piece to set piece, slowing any momentum the All Blacks get down.
First line-out throw for Tokiaho. Bad delivery for Smith. Snapped up, though, by Jordan. But the All Blacks very much on the back foot here as Aaron Smith waits. Decent scrap going on for the ball. In the end, it's carried on by Tokiaho. And Smith gets back to normal position. Mwanga under real pressure. Another midfield bomb. All Blacks get up high. Mwanga. Very nearly got him early, but the timing was okay. Look at the power of the box. Walking over the top. But this time illegally. Two totally different halves here.
Found out unlucky there. The Springboks have just lost their feet, just passed the ball. But you're right, Nisbo, you've seen the energy from the bench, from the Springbok bench, but they've also forced the All Blacks into a false sense where they feel they've still got a pretty big lead and starting to play a bit more expansive. On the back end of that, they're just, the Springboks are really putting some heat on at the breakdown, and they're slowing that ball down. They've had to send more numbers into that, trying to secure the ball at the All Blacks, and it's just been so scrappy.
No. Wait. On the line, Black. Close the gap, 2 meters.
Tokiaho. All Black line-out work tonight has been good. Again, unchallenged, Scott Barrett. Now, Frizzell in midfield. Smith got it away. He's under a lot of pressure, though.
No, hands up.
And this time he drags it out.
And on the ground first.
Mwanga, nice work. Got it away for Jordy Barrett. Now there's a bit of space for Adi Savia. Steps back in field. Now Smith. Mwanga once more. De Groot. Good charge by Ethan De Groot. Ball there. Mwanga works it off for Tokiaho. Real problem here. The Springboks have been piling into these rucks and balls.
Don't touch the scrum off. Don't touch the scrum off.
And they're going to have a look here. I think Jordy Barrett, with his distance.
What do we do, Captain? What do we do? Close.
And it's Richie Mwanga who's got the ball at the moment.
He bought it.
A sensible decision too.
You can pick up the ball.
They've just lost the away a little bit. The All Blacks at the back end with some energy from the Springboks. Nice little wee play as they roll back round. They've reloaded well, got out on the outside. Adi Savia makes a good decision to come back in field. And the Springboks once again showing real heat in that midfield. Disruptive, but unfortunately on that occasion, just took out the halfback. Important points here for the All Blacks. As I mentioned before, they've just lost that momentum.
Well, the heat's come on at the breakdown. It's constant. They're not conceding at any stage, the Springboks. They're not allowing the All Blacks to get any quick ball. They're losing that contact over the line. We see Richie Mwanga there carrying a little bit of claret over his right eye. They've lifted the intensity. That bench has come on and changed the momentum of the game.
As it so often does for the Springboks, and there are more to come. Here's Mwanga, 50 metres on the angle. Distance is good. What a kick that is from Richie Mwanga.
That's class, isn't it, from Mwanga, because he stepped up We know Jordy Barrett can easily make the distance. Nice little connection there. Watches it glide over. Plenty of distance, plenty of accuracy.
Thomas Du Toit, Vincent Kok, they're on for Kitsoff and Melchurba, and they've been impressive in the second half.
I think Finlay Christie's out there too. Jeff, as Vilimsa restarts. Taken down by Jordy Barrett. There is Christie. For the last 20 minutes of this absorbing test match. Does the job himself and hooks it into touch. Not a great deal of distance.
There he is as well. Tamaiti Williams on debut for the All Blacks in the biggest stage against one of the biggest rivals. What a moment for this young man. What a season it has been.
All Black number 1209. Marks throws. Clearly won by Du Toit. Now on to the rampaging Dwayne Familial. They're coming from everywhere now, the box. Here is Vilimsa, chased across, couldn't take him. Billy LaRue turns it back in for Colby. Oh, big tackle. Big tackle, Scott Barrett. Now here's Peter Steph Du Toit, looking to offload. Comes for Williams. Again, running it through Du Toit and away for Arm. Springbok starting to give the ball a little bit of air. Billy LaRue backing his way in as Williams sends it wide. All Blacks now having to make a lot more tackles. Williams away again. Beautiful pass for Colby. They'll have to check it.
The other front.
The referee's pulled up lame.
I've got a cramp.
You got a cramp? You're all right.
I've got a cramp.
Hey, do you want to get go to here? Come down on your back over here.
I think it's given a try. I think everyone's a bit stunned here.
Yeah, yeah,
I
reckon
they haven't checked upstairs to see if it's gone through.
It's okay.
Well, he initially awarded the try. I think they might still have to check this.
Huh? Yeah, okay.
Matthew, sorry, did you award the try?
Oh, we're going to get a really good angle here.
Let's have a look at this.
Yeah.
Try is good, lads. Try is good.
The TMO said the try is good. And the try was scored by Cheslin Colby. And he will attempt to convert it. He's a little bit distracted at the moment. He's got a cramp in his leg. I don't know whether he'll be able to go much further. Here's Colby's conversion. And... oh! Off the post.
The momentum shift has shifted. What a wonderful try. A great finish. Look at that. The beautiful dive. Change being made as well. Makazole Mpimpi, he has been replaced by Mani Lebok.
Still 17 minutes remaining in the game as Bowden Barrett restarts. And the Springboks claim possession. Now Williams from outside his 22. And it goes for Thomas Du Toit, replacement prop forward. Grant Williams. bouncing around, finally has been grabbed by the All Blacks. Tokiaho has it as Christie serves it up on the blind side for Talia.
Release.
And now they have to release as Christie away for Scott Barrett. Moonga. All Blacks trying to shift it away. Ioane just got the pass off to Jordan. Springboks swarming up in defence though. And Christie taken to halfway. Christie plugs the blind side. Bowden Barrett. Look at the Springboks pouring through here, making life very difficult indeed. As Geordie Barrett slings it wide for Moonga. Now Talia, hard to put away. Now Christie once more. Richie Moonga. They've got value out of the high kick tonight. But this time Billy LaRue is safe and secure. The All Blacks turn now to try and push the Springboks off the ball, and they get the penalty.
They are on the ground. Kunfarek is fine. They are on the ground.
Very good. From the All Blacks. Moonga, well, nothing really was on. Getting a little bit scrappy for the All Blacks. Puts the ball up in the air. But as he work off the ball in that counter ruck by Adi Savea in particular, pushing through. And whoever that was, I'm not sure who it was on the ground, just had to hold on that little bit longer.
Well, the crowd are back into the game because the All Blacks have all of a sudden, they've attacked the breakdown themselves, and it was important. Great body position. Work, Adi Savea, Scott Barrett. Keep working and playing the ball on the ground. But the decision, it's not three. They're chasing seven. Massive crowd, 31,261 on hand.
Tokiaho throws. Savea delivers. Christie away for Jordan. Danger man as always. Christie. Frizzell, so dominant in the first half. Christie again, Springboks up. Very, very flat and very quick. Now Scott Barrett going hard. Ball available for Christie, gets the call from Savea. Christie again, Barrett slips it to Retallick. All Blacks keeping it tight for the moment. Tokiaho.
Taco now.
Ball there for Christie. Now Christie again. Moonga. Bowden Barrett tries something a little bit different. And the ball drifting into touch. Came off a boot, came off a Springbok boot.
We're seeing a very, very good effort at the breakdown. Here's the boot, Colby. The breakdown from the Springboks. That ball is so messy. There you have it, Christie, asking for better service.
Change of centre for the All Blacks. Braden Enor comes on for Rico Ioane.
It's okay. Thanks for the sub.
Typical All Black Springbok test match. Tokiaho throws to the back. Frizzell wins it. Slips it nicely to Retallick. Momentum for a moment was good. Now it's coming for Finlay Christie. Geordie Barrett, down he goes. Christie goes short for Tokiaho. Ball there again for Christie. Now it's Dalton Papali'i, slips the first tackle. Springboks claiming they got to it. Epo Laulala on the charge. Papali'i. Energy sapping stuff, this. Odin Barrett. Very difficult to break the line. Scott Barrett. But they are retaining possession as Christie slings it away. Laulala could open up here. Enor away for Retallick. Christie. Laulala on the charge.
Offside.
Oh, offside. Call. All Blacks have a penalty advantage as Adi Savea makes a bit of ground. Now Christie. Change of direction. Little kick through. Here's a chance. Wow. Did he control it? He did. Will Jordan.
Oh, it was not as vintage as what we've seen in the first half, but it was something out of nothing. Brilliant kick here from Bowden Barrett. He sweeps around, no one in behind. It bounces kindly. Grounds it. Does Will Jordan.
It almost slipped through his fingertips just there. He sees it though, he regathers, and that's grounded. And that is beautiful from Bowden Barrett. The ability to play multiple phases to strain the defence for the Springboks. Under penalty advantage, that man scores another try for the All Blacks.
Yes, it wouldn't seem right if it was a test match and Will Jordan didn't score one. 22 test matches, 22 test tries.
Very nice change of direction, wasn't it, from Brayne Ennall sweeping down the short side. It's created an overlap which got him behind the defence, which got the Springboks under pressure. Impact from the bench being made.
See the referee in the background still stretching that leg. He's battling a bit, not even looking at this conversion, which is a great kick.
Tries being converted. Here we go, the sweep round from Bowden Barrett. You're right, referee getting some attention. He's been given some jout. Some coaches are happy in the All Black box.
30 to 15. I guess that's appropriate with Wimbledon on at the moment. As the ball bounces loose. Now, Dale Ende goes on a run. Williams quickly there, swings it away. New man on the field, Marnie Lubok, made such an impression against the Wallabies last week. Prepared to run at the opposition. Broken tackle here, and the pass gets away. Willems is still out there as Williams, again for Lubok. Now here's Dale Ende, lurking as Smith. Quagga Smith, they're riding him towards the touchline, but he does well to keep it in. Williams again. Billy LaRue charging hard was Vincent Cock. Good tackle by Christie. Had to be made. All Blacks might have turned this over. Yes, they have. Scott Barrett away for Moonga. And the All Blacks relieve the pressure with less than 10 minutes remaining in the test match. And another change, Jeff.
Couple of changes. Yep. Yep. Tupavai coming on. And Caleb Clark coming on for Mark Talia. And it's for Shannon Frizzell, and he deserves a massive round of applause. His first 40 minutes, impressive. He's worked tirelessly.
Yes, he's had a big one, all right. As the line-out throw is made by Marks. Sits up for Williams, but he cops a few All Blacks at the same time. 8 minutes left. Springboks have to score three times to win the game. Williams has got it now. Change of direction for Lubok. Chased hard by Christie. Finally gets his man and holds him up as well at the same time. And that's a turnover.
Excellent work there by Finlay Christie, because he wrapped his arms around, but then he understood the situation that he was in, that he was right underneath him, hold him up, get some support under Lubok. And keep him off the ground, turnover.
Happy in the All Black coaching box.
And they should be, because it's been an impressive effort. They've had to weather a storm in the second half, and they've done that.
Carries them up.
The Springboks, though, they've continued to try and play. Defence has been stout from the All Blacks. Classic test match between these two countries.
Chance in this game for the All Blacks to retain the Freedom Cup. Shared the series in South Africa last year.
Clutch! Bye!
Might might be the first scrum I think that Tamati Williams has got involved in. Going to win a penalty. Put that in the scrapbook.
One green. Binging.
Certainly will, won't he? Excellent from number 17. Young man, special moment. First test cap.
Quoted as saying before the game, Mills, every Maori boy's dream to play for the All Blacks. Wonderful little quote. That's a kick and a half too.
You can't say enough about Richie Mo'unga tonight in terms of controlling where the All Blacks have played the game, in the decision to run the kick, the accuracy of the high ball. They've made a shift here. That work was done up front by Nepo Lalala on the tight head side for the All Blacks at scrum time.
Where's the receiver? Okay.
All Blacks looking to put a full stop on this game. Tokiaho throws Retallick. Oh, they lost control for a moment, but Papali'i pounced on the loose ball. So it's still there. Snapped up by Tokiaho. Just edging across field. The hooker tries to go again. Makes good progress. And there it is. Snapped up by Savia. Tupo Vai'i freshly on the field. Ball's been stolen. But it's a penalty.
First in 3 months, run away, please. Run.
So, what do we do here? Mills?
Oh, I like the scrum, I think. Tamati Williams will get the head out. Second opportunity. Get amongst it. They just got them for not rolling away. Smith does a nice job to get over the ball and win it back, but it was just the ruck beforehand. Tough situation here for the box to be able to defend because of that blind. They have to consider that, which the box has done. And arm has gone across as well.
Phil Z and Foster wanted a statement to be made. Do you think it has been?
Oh, I certainly think so. They've come out of the block, 7-8, straight away. The All Blacks put some real heat on the Springbok outfit. But I've been impressed with their bench, the Springboks. Some of their big men coming on, their toy, Vermeulen, and also Williams.
Off the back comes Savia. Away it goes for Mo'unga! Richie Mo'unga! That is the full stop on the game.
Just as you like. Richie Mo'unga. Here it is, a nice little wee handshake. Celebrate the moment. Settled scrum, first and foremost. That's nice and stable. Ardie Savia has a nice little wee snipe. Puts Richie Mo'unga on the outside. He just glides over for the All Blacks try.
Platform as well was perfect. Square, strong. The loose forwards for the Springboks, they were held and he glides beautifully to the outside. The best of Richie Mo'unga. And I imagine eyes around the world will be watching an All Black side that has fronted. Watch the coaches and the fans.
Two tries in the first half, the All Blacks. Now two in the second. So Mo'unga attempting his own conversion. This time he misses for the first time this evening, but it hardly matters because the All Blacks now with a lead that can't be dented, 35-15. The restart from Lubbock, taken down by Bowden Barrett. It off for Caleb Clark, who heads off on a little mission of his own. Now Tupou Vaii. Christie. Quick ball for Moonga. Little jab kick. All Blacks trying to keep it alive. Enor running hard onto it. Makes a tackle though. The Springboks have the ball as Williams feeds it up to Willemsa. Turns it back for Dalende. Savia went for the ball. But the ball's been ripped away by Geordie Barrett. Now Ritali. Away through Takeoho. Moonga. Comes to a blinding halt in the face of Peter Steph Dutoy. Low pass accepted by Tokiaho. Ball left loose, and here's Quagga Smith. Quagga Smith for the Springboks. And he's in. I reckon he's got it over the line.
Yeah, he's got that down all right. Individual try from Quagga Smith.
To see if that ball was out.
No.
Oh, the conversion's missed.
Benny.
Tried a drop kick, and it hit the post.
Benny, all good.
So Smith gets a try. 35 points to 20, and it was an excellent individual effort. Clearly over the line.
Yeah, great work from Quagga Smith. Look at that. Just comes up short. He's got the ability and the right to go forward with momentum and scores a try for the Springboks.
Barely time for a kick-off. Let's see whether the referee says you have to kick it off. Much better second half by the Springboks. But the All Blacks have done enough. As the restart from Bowden Barrett. They go short. And it's fallen for Cheslin Colby. Springboks have got another chance here. Run down by Christie. And they've gone over the touchline. Up goes the flag. And the final whistle is blown. And the All Blacks have succeeded against the Springboks. They've retained the Freedom Cup. Final score.